NBC5 First Warning Weather with meteorologist Ben Frischette.
Time right now, 12:17 on your Wednesday afternoon. Taking a pause from election coverage to talk about the weather. It was chilly this morning, huh?
Feeling like November should feel this time of year, Sarah Beth. It was the coldest morning across the region of the season so far. We made it to the 20s in many towns across Vermont and New Hampshire. Some teens showing up, though, in the Adirondacks, northern New York, Messina down to 19 this morning. 15 in Saranac Lake and in the Burlington area, that 27 degrees, that's made for the coldest morning since March 30th. So it's been a while since we've seen this kind of cold weather around, but it's not super unusual. The average low for this day is 34 degrees, so only slightly cooler than normal for this morning. We're in the mid-40s right now from Burlington to Saranac Lake, some mid-40s in southern Vermont, slightly cooler in the Northeast Kingdom, 41 in Newport and St. Johnsbury, but we're working with a totally clear sky this afternoon. It's all attached to high pressure. Now, the actual center of high pressure is farther to our south, and that puts us in this northerly return flow. So that actually helps keep this rain and snow away and all the clouds in Canada. It's actually going to pivot around the high and impact parts of northern Maine. So we won't have to worry about that. The forecast is still dry through about Friday morning. And then we have to worry about Tropical Storm Nicole. Not so much because of the wind, but once it gets up here, the rain and all the leftover moisture will be falling across the region. Here's the latest update. Actually just made landfall in the northern Bahamas. Winds of 70 miles per hour and still moving in the general direction of Florida. Looks to make landfall just north of West Palm Beach sometime later today or perhaps early Thursday morning. And that'll make landfall perhaps as a weak Category 1 hurricane. But it's afterwards that we're paying attention to because it looks like the remnant circulation rides up the East Coast and eventually finds its way to the North Country. Now, this likely happens late in the day Friday, but look at all of the moisture with this system. So I'm thinking by 6, 7 o'clock Friday, it's already raining across most of the region. It's going to pour through most of the overnight and through a decent amount of Saturday, we could still find some decently heavy showers. It's not until Saturday evening and overnight where all of this finally starts to leave. It'll be quite a soaker, too. I think just about everybody gets at least an inch of rain. There's probably a swath in the Champlain Valley, parts of northern New York, that get over 2 inches. Wouldn't be surprised if we had an amount of 3 or so in there too. You may be wondering, well, what's the flooding risk look like? Well, because we're so dry leading up to this storm, it looks like our rivers and streams will be able to handle the additional runoff. But of course, that's something we'll watch very closely going forward. So for this afternoon, temperatures going up a couple more degrees, perfectly normal for this time of year. Seasonable with a light south breeze, not as cold overnight. Temperatures in the 30s and 40s for many towns. And then for tomorrow, breeze picks up out of the south. It'll send our temperatures back into the 60s. And a few more clouds will mix in, but we should still remain dry. So widespread afternoon rain on Friday. That will last into Saturday. A little bit of clearing late in the day. Could be a lingering shower on Sunday, but that looks like the drier of the two weekend days. And then we'll hang around in the 40s for all of next week. Sarah Beth.
All right, Ben.